A key element of Marquette's identity is its Jesuit roots. The university is one of 28 Jesuit collegiate institutions in America, and when it comes to Marquette's celebrated basketball program, there's no shortage of Jesuit influence. For 26 years, Father William Kelly has served as team chaplain. But aside from sitting at the end of the bench, most fans wonder, what does the role of chaplain entail?
Show kind of a Catholic identity, show your alums some Jesuit presence, to be available to the coaches and the teams in good times and in bad, because I'm so close to them and see what goes on in practice and what goes on the road. I have to be very careful about, you know, what I see and what I say. So that's about what it is now. Sacramental presence, availability, and a willing ear and encouragement.
I think it takes time, even for me, to genuinely appreciate what the Jesuits are about, what they stand for, and the consistency to who they are as human beings. I've yet to meet one Jesuit that's not somebody that you would want to be like, who doesn't set an example for how you should live.
Father Kelly cites Dwayne Wade as a former bench buddy and says he maintains a good relationship with the NBA superstar among all of the Marquette greats he's grown to know. The chaplain's delight comes in seeing the true Jesuit mission play out in the players' community actions. But for the avid sports fan, his excitement doesn't stop there.
Even as I get older and older, I take these losses much harder than the kids. They have to go right back to work the next day. I have to linger with the loss and put up with all of the nitpicking that the newspapers do with why we lost and all that.
Win or lose, he's always bringing the good out and everything. So when you see him on the bench, it's like when you look down there, you know, everybody's thinking that everything's going to be okay.
When he tells us different types of stories and tell us about, oh, years back when Wade was here or when Lucas was here and his experience with them, you know, it just brings us kind of like a story time, like a bunch of little kids.
Speaking of the current Golden Eagles, Father Kelly called Buzz Williams a master and said he's been very impressed by the third-year coach. He also said that he has plenty of fun with the players off the court and said Joe Fultz and Vander Blue are the leaders of the Father Kelly Impressions Club. His impact on this program, both as a Jesuit influence and as a wise advisor, is immeasurable.
The young guys come and they're like, I wonder who that old guy is over there. And then they don't know the prayer, you know, that we say every day before the game. And so I just think it takes time. But I think that what they gain from that experience, they understand before they leave, which I think is healthy. I think it's good.
If he wasn't there, a big part of our program would be missing.
How we talk on the bus, how we talk on the plane and everything, you know, if you don't hear Father's voice, you know, something's not right. Something's not right with the flow of how we process things. And just his presence there just means a lot to us.
I'm accepted, and I also would realize that this is not going to last forever. And so if the coach or the administration get tired of it, why, I'll graciously go into retirement. But as long as I can do it and they don't have any objection to it, I'll do it.